Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 5.5, Problem 15. This is Section 5.5, Problem number 15. It says Jordan has to create a new password to log into his computer at work. His password must consist of 5 letters and 3 numbers. So, Part A says, how many passwords can be made if the letters are case sensitive? And by case sensitive, that means that capital A and lowercase a are considered 2 different numbers. So some passwords are case sensitive and some are not. So what this is it's a question using the multiplication principle, and it's really a 2-stage application of the multiplication principle. So first, when we apply the multiplication principle, which tells you that the total number of outcomes possible are the number of options at step 1 times the number of options at step 2 times the number of options at step 3 for as many steps as you have. So first, what you have to do is calculate how many different ways you can choose the letters and multiply times how many different ways you can choose the numbers. So that's our first application of our multiplication principle. Now, to choose the letters, how many ways can you choose the letters? That's the multiplication principle again. So there are 5 letters to choose. So we can even set this up with 5 boxes to choose our letters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we have 3 numbers. So 1, 2, 3. And again, I'll just say that these are letters, the first 5 positions. And the last 3 are numbers, just to be clear, like what we're plugging in our values for. So now, in terms of the letters, there are 52 letters in the alphabet. Oh, sorry, 26 letters in the alphabet. But I was going with the 52 because when they're case sensitive, essentially it becomes 52 letters in the alphabet. Because 26 lowercase plus 26 more capital combined for a total of 52. So when the letters are case sensitive, and each one of the boxes for the letters, there are 52 different choices. Right? 26 lowercase and 26 capital in each one of the boxes for the letters. Now for the numbers, you have 10 choices for each number. Right? And those 10 choices are the digits 0 through 9. Those are your 10 choices. So this is how many different ways we can make a password that consists of 5 letters and 3 numbers when the letters are case sensitive. Now it's too big to multiply out without the aid of a calculator. So let's say I put this on a test or quiz and you filled out this much and stopped. That would be fine for full credit. So just out of curiosity, what is it? It's going to, I would guess, go like into the billions. So let's see, if I do 52, I can just raise that to the 5th power. It's the same as 52 times 52 times 52. And it's going to be 1,000 after with the 10 times 10 times 10. So that comes out to 380204032000. 380 billion. Different passwords that you can make using the system. Pretty tough to hack just by guessing at it. So that's part A. B says, how many passwords can be made if the letters are case sensitive but there are no repeats? So you can't use the same letter twice and you can't use the same number twice. So you couldn't have like 88 and the same letter. Remember, it's case sensitive, so you could have like, say, capital B then lowercase b. You couldn't have capital B, capital B. And they don't have to be next to each other either when I say no repeats. So you couldn't have like capital B in position 1 and capital B again in position 4. You just can't have anything repeated. So for your 5 choices for letters, it would start with 52 choices. But if there's no repeats, the next position would have 51 choices. Then after that, you'd have 50. Then after that, you'd have 49. I use 1, 2, 3, 4 letters, so one more. Then 48. So that's how many different choices you'd have to choose your letters, your case-sensitive letters. And then for your numbers with no repeats, there's still 10 choices for the first number, 0 through 9. But if you can't repeat a number either, then you'd be down to 9 choices for the second, then down to 8 choices for the last. And again, if you put this on a test or a quiz and stopped here and you indicated clearly that you intend to multiply them, that would be fine for full credit. But just out of curiosity, how many would there be? And since you're limiting your number of choices a little bit, it would have to be a little bit less than the result for Part A. Part A was 380 billion and something. This will have to be less. So let me multiply this through. 52 times 51 times 50 times 49 times 48, takes care of the letters, then times 10 times 9 times 8. So what that's going to be is 2, 2, 4, 5, 0, 1, 4, 4. And the calculator didn't go into scientific notation on me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So the number that my calculator is giving me is a little over 224 billion. Still a lot, less than not restricting the repeats. So this is how many passwords could be made, 5 letters, 3 numbers, case sensitive on the letters, but no repeats. So that's B. This is the answer for B. Up here we had the answer for A, just to be clear. Now C says, how many passwords can be made if the letters are not case sensitive? And notice it doesn't mention anything about repeats. So the letters are not case sensitive. Capital A and lowercase a are considered the same letter. So now our number of options for letters goes back down to 26, which you would be more familiar with. It's not 52 anymore. You're not counting capitals and lowercase differently. So to choose your 5 letters, the number of options would be 5 26s multiplied together. 1, 2, 3, 4, one more, 5. And then for your 3 numbers, again, it doesn't mention repeats, so you can repeat the numbers if you want. So 5 26s multiplied together, you'd have 26 options for each letter that you choose. And then 3 tens multiplied together, you'd have 10 choices for each number that you choose. And let's multiply that out. And my calculator tells me that that comes out to 1,1,8,8,1,3,7,6. And then I have to put the 3 zeros on it. So that's 11 billion, almost 12 billion, still a lot, but quite a bit less than when the letters are case sensitive. So passwords with case sensitive letters are a little bit more secure. And that's C. So finally, D, how many passwords can be made if the letters are case sensitive and there are no repeats? So they're not case sensitive. So again, capital A and lowercase a are considered the same letter, but there are no repeats. So when you say there are no repeats, on the first choice for your 5 letters, you have 26 options to choose from. But if there are no repeats, on the second choice, you have 25 options to choose from. Then 24 for the third, 23 for the fourth, and then 22 for the fifth one. Then for your numbers, when you start choosing the numbers, you still have 10 choices for the first number, but no repeats, you're down to 9, and then for the last one, down to 8. So that's what we'd have to multiply out, 26 times 25 times 24 times 23 times 22 times 10 times 9 times 8. And again, on a test or quiz, that's far enough for full credit. But just out of curiosity, what does that actually multiply out to? 26 times 25 times 24 times 23 times 22 times 10 times 9 times 8. And that gives me 5, 6, 8, 3, 3, 9, 2, 0, 0, 0. So a little over 5.5 billion different passwords, letters not case sensitive, no repeats.